is Amanda and I'm here with my July wrap-up. I read a total of 16 books this month, of which I owned 9, and in total I read 5,057 pages. So let's go down more on stats. I don't really have much to say for an intro, so we're just doing the stats. I read 2 books that were out of my comfort zone, 3 sequels, 5 new books, and 3 TBR vets. I read 2 2-stars, 4 3-stars, 6 4-stars, and 3 5-stars. I read 13 books by female authors, 2 books by male authors, and 1 by a non-binary author. Then I read 1 children's book, 5 middle grades, 7 YAs, and 3 adult books. I read 1 paranormal, 5 contemporary books, 1 manga, 5 fantasies, 2 non-fictions, and 2 graphic novels. And of course you can split up manga and graphic novels and non-fiction as well into different genres. I just prefer not to do that because I don't read that much of them, so it makes more sense to just like put them together as they are. This month I participated in Becca's Book Uploadathon, which I have a vlog for up on my channel, which I'll link down below. And I've also done a mid-month wrap-up, which I'll also leave linked down below. I talked about the books that I read during Becca's Book Uploadathon in that wrap-up. Let's just quickly go over the books that I already talked about, and then I have, I believe, 7 more books. Yes, 7 more books that I need to talk to you about more in depth. This is gonna be a bit of a quicker one, hopefully. So let's just begin. The first book for this month is Mayhem by Stella Lore, which I read a galley off from NetGalley, and I gave 2 out of 5 stars. Then I read George by Alex Gino, which I got from the library and had to return, and I gave 4 out of 5 stars. Then I read Isaiah Dunn Is My Hero by Kyla G. Baptist, which again is a galley I got from NetGalley, and I gave 4 out of 5 stars too. Then I read Children of the Whales Volume 1 by Abby Umeda, and I gave this 4 out of 5 stars. Then I read The Blood of Olympus by Rick Riordan, which I gave 5 out of 5 stars. And I have a series discussion for the series up on my channel. Then I read From Tinkle with Love by Sandra Manon, which I gave 3 out of 5 stars. Then I read The Trials of Morwick and Quo by Jessica Townsend, which I gave 4 out of 5 stars. Then I read Why I'm No Longer Talking to White People About Race by Rennie Edward Lodge, which I got from the library and had to return, and I gave 5 out of 5 stars. And then lastly, for the month wrap-up, I read My Dog Vanessa by Elizabeth Whistle, which I gave 2 out of 5 stars. I only have 7 books to talk to you about. First, starting off with Fangs by Sarah Anderson, which I gave 4 out of 5 stars, and the galley I got from NetGalley. This is a graphic novel about a vampire and a werewolf who are in a relationship, and just cute slice of life kind of graphic novel. And I really liked it. I really liked that there wasn't anything special to it, so I didn't really give that much of a high rating, but it was a cute, quick read that I enjoyed requesting. And I think if you like Sarah Anderson's comics, I think you'll also really like this one because it's very much in the style, except that it's paranormal now. And yeah, but it's cutesy, it's fun, there's not a lot of substance to it, so I don't know, you decide if you want to read it or not. Then the next book I read is The Iron Knight by Julia Kagawa, which I gave 2 out of 5 stars. This is the last book in the Iron Fae series, which follows Megan, who her little brother gets kidnapped by Fae, and she has to go back into the fairy realm to find her little brother, except that she also learns that she is actually Hell Fae, and she is the daughter of the Summer Court King, and that her best friend is actually a fae sent out by her father to protect her the whole time that she was in the human realm. More stuff happens, but I feel like that's most of the synopsis you should know before going into the series. But yeah, the last book follows a different perspective than Megan, actually. It follows Ash, and if you read the series or just the first book, you already know what that is. But we follow Ash as he goes on his adventure of his own. And I was actually really looking forward to having a different perspective because I don't like Megan at all. She was so annoying and I hated reading from her perspective throughout the first 3 books of the series. But I do have to say, I was a little bit disappointed. I felt like Ash was more of like a, like sort of like whiny etch-a-lord. That's the best way I feel like I could describe him. And I didn't like that much. And also just the plot was very bland. I just felt like there wasn't a lot happening, and I feel like this could have been better if it had either more perspectives, because we do follow because I just go on this adventure with like a bunch of other people, so I feel like it could have been interesting if we had like more perspectives, or if this was just like a beeline, like we had a storyline with Megan like always, and then this was a like second perspective to that. I feel like that would have worked, because this story definitely gonna be reduced to like a novella or something, which I at first thought was like, oh my god, why couldn't this just be a novella? And then when I finished, it's like, oh yeah, this is too long to be a novella. But it kind of, it's not long enough to have like its own novel just with it, because that was just too boring and too slow, and it didn't really work well for me. There's also a whole lot of flashbacks in this, which I also didn't enjoy. By the way, this is a bind up of book 3 and 4 before you're like, oh my god, that's so big. But we do have a lot of flashbacks in the last novel, which I just also wasn't a fan of. I don't mind flashbacks, but this was felt like almost 50-50 flashbacks and normal plotline, and that was just a little bit too much for me. Then the next book I read is NIK by Jenny Lee, which I gave 45 stars. This is an anachronary telling which follows a bunch of different characters, but the back only mentions NIK. NIK is like a very like normal girl. She doesn't really get into trouble. She's very much on her own and a little bit studious. She has been dating this guy for a while and they're like set to be married someday, but because the relationship is just going that well, their families really like each other. And then one day she randomly comes across this guy who's kind of known to be a player, and they end up feeling attractions for each other. Yeah, there's a whole lot of other perspectives in this. It takes a while before we get to Anna's perspective, so I feel like it's weird that just marketed, like the back just talks about Anna but nobody else. But yeah, we follow a bunch of different characters in here. It's a lot of drama and relationship stuff and witch people stuff. If you like Gossip Girl, you'll probably like this book as well. Not the biggest Gossip Girl fan, but I love this book. Another book if you like the Thousand Floor series, you probably will also like this, because if you like witch people drama, you'll love this. But that's basically what I'm saying. And yeah, I really enjoyed this. It's not like a new favorite, because I did have some problems with it. I felt like some perspectives were, it was at other points I was definitely more interested in some perspectives than others, and we're just like, oh my god, why are we doing this? I want to go back to the other storyline. There were just some characters I was more invested in than others, and I felt like I could have been balanced a little bit better. But I really liked the storyline, and like the drama was just like a fun read and very addictive. Like I flew through this book, and even though it isn't the biggest, the font is like tiny. Oh my god, I was so shocked when I began reading that this font is so little. I still really flew through this and I really enjoyed it, and it's a lot of fun. It does deal with a couple more serious topics, and it does that very well, but I feel like there was enough of a balance between like lightheartedness and like these deeper topics that it just didn't become like very depressing, which I also really enjoyed. Now the next book I read is The Girl Who Speaks Bear by Sophie Anderson, illustrated by Catherine Honesta. Sorry if I mispronounced that, but this book I gave 45 stars. This follows a girl who as a baby, I don't remember how old she was, but like as a toddler, baby-ish age, she got found at a like bear's lair, and since then she has been growing up in this town, but she always felt out of place and like felt like this call towards like the forest that they live at, close to. And then one day her feet start to turn into bear feet, and she gets concerned and she goes out into the forest to find out what really, like, her origin story, basically, to know where she came from, where this call is coming from, and if people know more about like her heritage in the woods. And yeah, I thought this was a fun middle grade novel. It has gorgeous illustrations. Let me find one real quick that isn't spoilery. Over here, the illustrations are great, and I liked how they were put in throughout the novel. And I just thought this was a cute story, and I just think this would be a great read for middle grade audience. And I would highly recommend it. I've been really in like a middle grade mood recently, in case you didn't notice it from the step up. So if you have some middle grade recommendations that you think like translate over well to like older age, let me know in comments, because I need more recs. I do think this is like a fantastic story for children, but also I feel like as someone who is older, you can still get a lot out of it. It has some great messages, which I really liked. It has a big cast of animals, which I really enjoyed. I thought it was a lot of fun. I think there were some funny moments in here. Again, it does have a couple of like those more serious moments, but it's a cute, fun adventure, and I would recommend it. Then next, I read The Lightning Thief, the graphic novel by Rick Riordan, adapted by Robert Venditti, illustrated by Attila Futaki and Jose Villarrubia. I don't know if I pronounced any of that correctly, but now I do have to say that I tried to attempt to do the reading wish. I have to say it because otherwise reading this doesn't make sense really. We had tried participating in that and then I fell off like halfway through the week because I just wasn't feeling it. But I still read this, which was to read a book that has like a movie adaptation already seen, and I don't want to reread anything, so I read this, which was just something I bought because I love Percy Jackson and I wanted to have this, not because I actually wanted to read it. But now I read it anyway. I didn't give this a rating. This is a graphic novel adaptation of the first Percy Jackson novel. I don't feel like I explained Percy Jackson to you. And let's find the panel that I thought was beautiful. There we go. That's some of the art in here. I didn't give this a rating because this is just basically a summary of the first book. So it felt weird reading this. If you want to know, The Lightning Thief was a 5-star book for me. So there you go. But yeah, I just thought this was fun. The art at certain points I thought was beautiful, and then at other points I was like, it's not how I imagined that character to look like or how I imagined that thing to look like, and it doesn't really look that great. But yeah, I don't really have that much more to say about this. The next book I read is Goodnight Stories for Rebel Girls, 100 Immigrant Women Who Changed the World by Elena Favidi, which I gave 5 stars. It's not a galley I got from that galley. This doesn't come out until October, so normally I wouldn't have read this, but I just got too excited and I read it. Basically, this is a series of books about just like little one-page stories about like these women that changed the world in some way or another. They just like did something great, and this one is particularly focused on immigrant women, so women who have immigrated from one country to another. And yeah, I just think these are such great books, especially because they are targeted towards like a middle grade-ish audience, I would say. I feel like you could read them to a little bit of a younger audience, but like, you know, they are targeted towards kids mainly, and just think these are great. If I was a kid, I would have loved these because they're very inspiring and just fantastic. I like the way the stories are told. I love the illustrations. They have like a mix of illustrators, all female illustrators throughout these books. It's not just like one illustrator per book. It is many different ones. I don't know exactly how many, but there's a bunch. And I really like how these are made. Then the last book I read about this month is The Iron Legends by Julie Kagawa, which I gave 2 out of 5 stars. This is a novella binder for the Iron Fae series. I better give you an explanation what the series is about. And should I break down by novella what I said? So the first novella, which is Winter's Passage, I give 2 out of 5 stars. I didn't really think it was that necessary. It was a bit boring. They didn't really have a lot of stakes, but it was a little bit of fun. Then my favorite is Summer's Questing, which is the second one, which I gave 4 out of 5 stars. This follows Puck's perspective, and I really enjoyed it. I felt like his personality really shone through the narration, and I can appreciate that. And just the story was a lot of fun. It followed Ash and Puck doing something, which I can't really explain because of spoilers. And I liked seeing them hang out and like become friends more. And yeah. Then the last one is The Iron's Prophecy, which I also gave 2 out of 5 stars because I thought it was a little bit boring. And I felt like it could have been condensed a bit more, but I think it's like the last time we get to see like our crew together like that, which just was a bit sentimental to me. And I also felt like it did a great job at making me more excited for The Lost Prince, but I also feel like it didn't give that much information for me to be just like, oh my god. It gave like a little hint that it was just like, I could have had a little bit more. Would have been happy with that. And then at the end it also has just like a guide to the world, which I kind of skimmed over because it's very repetitive of like the rest of the series, and they're very much still in my brain. So I don't know, I skimmed over that a bit. I don't think these novellas were necessarily necessary. These were a bit boring besides the Summer's Crossing one. I really liked that one. For those, I thought they were a little bit like boring and like, I don't know, just felt like, what's the point a little bit. My actual like average rating was 3.33333333, endless trees. But yeah, I'm still glad I read it. I'm sorry, but that's all I have to say for this wrap up. Most of the books I read in the second half of the month were like books I didn't really have that much to say on, so it's a shorter wrap up. I'm so sorry for that, but I couldn't predict this at the middle of the month, so here we are. And yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video nonetheless, And let me know in the comment section below if you read any of these books, what you thought of them, so we can discuss them, as well as what are some of the books you read this month. And I guess I'll see you guys next time. Good.